Thanks. I must break this image which has been made that I do not smile, but I do smile from my heart. So to travel from the heart to my face, it takes a little time. So that's why you don't see it very often, probably. Well, it's a great honor to be invited in this kind of a function, because I have realized over the years that the doctors, the engineers, the intelligent people of the society, they don't take artists very seriously as far as such gatherings are concerned. So that's why it's really, really an honor that they, the Upasani family thought that it's okay if an actor comes for this kind of a function. So thanks so much for that. Well, I have a very deep connection with medical field, medicine field, because my doctors, my cousins, they are doctors, I mean, and uncles, my cousins, they have been doctors, and I have seen this field very closely. I studied in Belgaum for 3 years, and I stayed with my uncle who was a doctor. So that was one connection. When I came back to Solapur and when I started doing my theater, our director was a radiology department head in the civil hospital of Solapur. And all our meetings and rehearsals used to happen in the medical college in the civil hospital of Solapur. And that way as well, I was quite connected to the field of medicine. I'm also a person who is and who has been interested in technology. And the combination of these two have, you know, made me think a lot of times about what is happening, and of course the reading that you do in this regard. These days people say that doctors are almost 50% engineers. They are not only doctors, they are engineers as well. And when I was listening to the presentations, the words like artificial intelligence, like alloy, you know, like machines, all these words were spoken about. I think about 95% of the presentation was about the technology, and 5% probably or 10% was about the actual anatomy, maybe. So here we see engineers sitting here with the degree of a doctor. And all this brings us to two very important things that have been spoken all over the world, not only in India, all over the world. One being what this combination of artificial intelligence and biotechnology is going to do to the human race in general. You must have heard about Yuval Noah Harari, who has written great books like Sapiens, like Homo Deus, and latest book, which is called 21 Solutions to 21st Century. And not only him, many people are talking about this marriage of artificial intelligence and biotechnology. And there are people who are predicting that we are not, there are not going to be Homo sapiens as we know, the humans as we know, few years down the line, and we will be a different species altogether. Harari calls it Homo Deus. In simple ways, what is this? It is combination of machine and human. And they start with very simple examples, which actually can be related to a person like me who has been using contact lenses for last about 20 years. So I am a combination in a way of a machine and a human body. And it is going to go further with, as I said, the amalgamation of artificial intelligence and biotechnology. And we are heading towards a very crucial period in the history of mankind, where right now we do not know what this technology is going to do to human beings. It is not a scary thought, please. It's a very interesting thought. Because we as a species have been changing. We were not wearing clothes, for example, and today we find hardly any human being not wearing clothes. So this is a part of technology. So it is not something to be scared of, but definitely it is something to be aware of as a society, as professionals, and especially as professionals and the people interested in medical science. It's extremely important that we are aware of what is happening, what engineering is doing to medical science. And that is one field, I think, which is extremely important. And especially today's function, when I was listening to the whole thing, it's not very far, because a very important concept that Dr. Tejas mentioned, and I was taken aback a bit, and he said, we are heading towards a surgery which is not surgeon dependent. I think that's a big thing. We are going to a doctor with a belief that I'm not going to be dependent on you. I'm going to be dependent on a machine which will not let you pierce into the bone further or not. So I'm depending on a machine more than you. That is exactly what the presentation said, no?
I'll correct you.
Yeah.
It is not surgeon dependent for the mistakes or what will happen.
Exactly.
But the planning and everything is surgeon dependent.
Yeah.
So it is not completely independent of the surgeon. So I'm correcting you. It is surgeon dependent only.
which I think, from a patient's point of view, I am more dependent on the machine because it will not let the doctor make a mistake. Correct?
Doctor, right?
So this is what needs to be clarified. It is not completely surgeon independent. It has to be dependent on the surgeon. Only the execution part is with the help of the robot. Yeah. So it's assisted. It's not totally robotic. It's
in 2019.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know what's going to happen here.
That is precisely what is being taught throughout the world, as I said, that we do not know where it is heading. And Harari actually says that we might get away with surgeons. I'm so sorry, but this is point. But the point being that technology is definitely going to affect our lives on one side. The other important side is the business part of it, which affects the common man. Because technology needs money. Medical science needs investment. So it is like a small scale or a big scale industry that we are seeing today. And the end user, being the patient, being the person, definitely like any other business, it is going to affect the end user, the patients, because there is an investment which is involved. The combination of these two things, because naturally when the cost is being transferred to a patient and the patient transfers it to an insurance company, there is going to be a circle, there is going to be a weight added on to the next level from the hospital, to the patient, to the insurance company, and to the premium that would be charged to the patient. How many people are going to afford that premium? Everything. So this economics. So on one side there is technology, and on the other side there is economics. The combination of all these things, I think, brings us to someone like the Upasani family who is aware of these things. And that is why such dialogues, such functions are extremely important. Because on one side, as we saw an excellent presentation of the robot who is going to perform, who is going to assist the surgeons to perform in 2019 to, you know, have better service to the patients. But such opportunities, and that is why I'm overwhelmed with today's function, is that this opportunity to think about the future and to be aware of where we are heading and at what cost, I think, is something that we all should be thinking about along with the experts. And that's why my first sentence, that I'm really honored, I'm really happy that I'm part of such a dialogue, such a thing which is exchanging knowledge of modern technology, of medical science. And I really thank the Upasani family, and I wish them all the best in the endeavor. And of course, they have done great work in medical science, serving the patients. And they're going one step further every day, if I may say so. So I really wish them luck. And I'm sure that this new technology that they have brought to India, to this country, is going to introduce a simpler way, an easier way, a more precise way to the patients who are suffering so much from the knee pain these days. Thanks so much for listening to me, and thanks so much for inviting me.